It is a great pleasure for me to speak to all of you this morning on the occasion of the India-Bangladesh Joint Symposium in Chemical Crystallography and Structural Chemistry. This symposium follows from the observance of 2014 as the International Year of Crystallography. The International Year of Crystallography, or IYCR, was a major event in our subject, celebrating as it did past accomplishments and future prospects. One of the stated aims of the International Year was to bring countries together, and in this context the International Union of Crystallography, that organized the year with the cooperation of UNESCO, has developed a number of initiatives for the spread of crystallography in various parts of the world where this subject has not been developed to such a large extent. This includes Africa, South and Central America, and parts of Asia. Now, I am also privileged to speak to you in the capacity of immediate past president of the IUCR, and when I was the president, the International Year was inaugurated at a function in UNESCO Paris. The concluding ceremony occurred this year in Rabat, Morocco, a few months ago. Now, as part of this whole theme of bringing countries together, I suggested last year to Professor Malla Reddy of ICER Calcutta that he try and organize a meeting of structural chemists, chemical crystallographers, what you will, from India and Bangladesh. I should also add that one of the major initiatives of the IYCR were three summit meetings held in Asia, Africa, and South America. The meeting in Asia was held in April 2014 in Karachi, Pakistan, and brought together scientists from a large number of Asian countries. One of the resolutions of the Karachi summit was that we develop and strengthen crystallographic ties between the various countries of the region. Now, of course, the Indian subcontinent is one of the major arenas of scientific work in South and East Asia, and therefore my suggestion to Professor Malla Reddy really followed from this. I do believe there were a few scientists from Bangladesh at the Karachi summit, and I am so very happy to see a large number of you in Calcutta today. Now, the idea of holding this symposium in the eastern part of India is of course a natural one. I mean, West Bengal and Bangladesh share a common language, a common culture, and a common tradition. We also have smooth and nice relations, political relations between our two countries, and therefore to a large extent the fact that we have not had a big meeting of crystallographers from India and Bangladesh could simply be that we haven't bothered to organize a meeting like this. Now, in this respect, I would like to thank the authorities of ICER Calcutta for having willingly agreed to host this meeting here. Having the meeting in Calcutta is obvious. Calcutta, of course, is a center of so much crystallographic activity. There are a number of major institutions where crystallography of a high level is done in Calcutta. It is so very close to Bangladesh, and it becomes a natural and convenient place where meetings like this can be held. I do believe that a meeting like this should not be a one-off event. There should be many more things of this kind. Why only in structural chemistry? Why only chemical crystallography? You can also have meetings in macromolecular crystallography, in physical crystallography, structural metallurgy and so on. Many of these topics are being done well in both the countries, and a meeting like this is an occasion for all of you to get to know each other. Crystallographers from India get to know their counterparts in Bangladesh, and those in Bangladesh should get to know their counterparts in India. I think there should be a free and easy movement of students between the two countries. There should be a movement of postdocs between the two countries. There should also be a movement of senior researchers between the two countries. It is very, very easy and simple for us to travel to each other's countries and to live there comfortably for shorter or longer periods of time. And I think that carrying out such activities will reaffirm really the unifying nature of science. Now, the important thing here is that, and this is one of the stated aims of the IYCR, which the UN itself emphasized when it gave the responsibility to UNESCO to work with the IUCR in conducting the international year. One of the stated aims is that science is a way of bringing people and countries together. Many things divide countries: economics, politics, language, religion, culture, many things. Science is one of the unifying factors that actually brings countries together. All of us do the same science wherever we are. Bragg's law applies equally in India and Bangladesh. We do not have a different Bragg's law in the two countries. It is very important that I think youngsters, especially in the two countries, start appreciating this. You youngsters have the advantage that you do not carry the political baggage of the past. Much of this does not mean too much to you, and quite rightly so. I think when you see countries of Europe who have fought bitter wars getting together and behaving like a similar political economic unit, a unit that even shares the same currency, I think what we are doing in the subcontinent is actually quite silly. And especially in the case of Bangladesh and India, there are no real political differences, as I pointed out. So I would feel and hope that this meeting should set a trend for various kinds of activities that are going on. Now, I will come to a few more points. Firstly, Bangladesh and the International Union. Bangladesh has been associated with the International Union of Crystallography for a long time. Right now, it is a member in what is called the associate category, along with Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand and Vietnam. Now, the associate membership is typically meant for groups of countries where crystallographic activity is still growing, and it is meant to be a stepping stone to achieving full membership. Now, of these countries that I have mentioned in your associate group, Singapore has already applied for and secured full membership of the Union. Now, I sincerely feel that Bangladesh is also at a corresponding stage today. I think crystallographic work going on in Bangladesh is certainly of a quantity and quality where you can make a strong case for admittance into the Union as a full member. Let me also remind you that in order for this membership to be considered by the General Assembly of the Union, which is the only body that can take an action on this, the application to the IUCR should be made by around June or July of next year. So, I would certainly urge my colleagues in Bangladesh to make a proper proposal in consultation with the IUCR. And the IUCR, you are not strangers to the IUCR, you have already been there, you have been participating in its meetings, and it would not be very difficult, I believe, for you to make a membership and submit it to the Union about a year from now, so that it will be taken up at the General Assembly meeting 2 years from now. And where would this General Assembly meeting be? It would be in India. Please remember that the next Congress and General Assembly of the IUCR is being held in Hyderabad in India, August 21st to 28th, 2017. This is the most major function that is organized by the IUCR every 3 years. India joined the Union in 1951, but it has taken this long for a Congress to be given to India. All of us in India are very happy and pleased that the IUCR Congress is being held in our country in 2017. And please consider this a cordial invitation to all crystallographers in Bangladesh and structural chemists too, to attend the Congress in Hyderabad in large numbers. Now, after I speak about IUCR, how can I not speak about ASCA, the Asian Crystallographic Association, of which Bangladesh is a member country and whose president, Professor Pinak Chakrabarty, is with you today and is inaugurating this meeting. Now, more importantly, ASCA will be conducting its annual meeting in Calcutta this year in the month of December. Once again, let me say, Calcutta is not very far from Bangladesh, and so I would invite all of you to attend the ASCA meeting in large numbers. Perhaps you can tell those of your colleagues who are not here at this joint meeting today to come to the ASCA meeting in Calcutta in December, and all of you should really be coming to the Congress in Hyderabad in 2017. Professor Chakrabarty, no doubt, will tell you lots more about ASCA. It promises to be a very good meeting. I myself will be there personally. Naturally, I must, because ASCA is one of the regional associates of the Union, and as a responsible member of the Executive Committee of the Union, I think I will be there. Two other members of the Union Executive from Asia will also be there, Professor Gus from Australia and Professor Takata from Japan, and many other crystallographers from the Asian region. ASCA has been a traditional meeting ground of crystallographers from Asia. It is very typical and characteristic that we have decided to hold the ASCA meeting in the eastern part of India. The eastern part of India is our gateway to Asia, and this is why we are holding the meeting itself in Calcutta. Now, having said these things, I would leave you now to enjoy this two-day workshop that has been organized so ably by Professor Mallareddy and his friends and colleagues in the department. My very best wishes to all of you, and I hope that the proceedings of your two-day deliberations will be a grand success. Thank you very much indeed, one and all.